There's just something in my eye, that's all. Welcome to Ms. Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 animated Disney endings that will make you cry. Before we begin, we publish new content every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. For this list, we're looking at the final shots from Disney and Pixar's animated films that made us sniffle and weep. We're basing our choices on a mix of sad moments and the overwhelmingly cheerful scenes that made our eyes water for much happier reasons. Also, these are movie endings, so a spoiler warning is in order. Number 10, Aladdin. In his rise from a thief to a hero, Aladdin befriends a magic genie, courts Princess Jasmine, and fights the evil Jafar. But as he saves his city, Aladdin's victory is brought down by the laws preventing him from marrying Jasmine.
Well, I guess this is goodbye.
Oh, that stupid law. This isn't fair. I love you.
Al, no problem. You still got one wish left.
Despite this personal struggle, he uses his final wish to keep a promise to his enchanted friend. Aladdin is barely surviving at the start of the film, so using this magic to help someone else is a heartwarmingly selfless gesture.
Genie, I'm gonna miss you.
Me too, Al. No matter what anybody says, you'll always be a prince to me.
It's also upsetting to watch given how this nearly ruins his perfect love story. The fact that Genie himself tells Aladdin to wish for a romantic ending only adds more emotion to his noble choice.
But Genie, what about your freedom?
Hey, it's only an eternity of servitude.
This is love.
Number 9, Pinocchio. Through his journey to become a real boy and save his father Geppetto, Pinocchio ends up swallowed by a giant whale. While escaping the massive beast, however, the wooden puppet ends up drowning before he gets to shore.
Save yourself, Pinocchio.
Pinocchio! Oh, Pinocchio! Pinocchio!
This death alone is heavy for the audience to take in, but it's painful to watch as Geppetto bends over in sorrow for his son.
My boy. Brave little boy.
Jiminy Cricket's little eye wipes also turn on the waterworks with ease. Heck, even Figaro the cat is bawling. Seeing everyone's overwhelming grief for Pinocchio, it's hard not to tear up during this overtly dark scene, or shed tears of joy when he's given a second shot at life courtesy of the Blue Fairy.
Prove yourself brave, truthful, and unselfish, and someday you will be a real boy. Awake. Awake.
Number 8, Monsters, Inc. Mike and Sully travel through doors to scare children for work, but meeting a girl named Boo changes their priorities.
You go to sleep.
After exposing his sinister boss, Sully is left to reluctantly return Boo home and never see her again.
Nothing's coming out of your closet to scare you anymore, right? Yeah. Goodbye, Boo.
Kitty.
Kitty has to go.
Their final hugs get your eyes welling up, while Boo's attempt to go back through the door is utterly heartbreaking. Though it's alternatively stirring to see how excited all the monsters are to be entertaining kids for their updated jobs, Sully's bittersweet ending is more difficult to swallow. Luckily, Monsters, Inc. closes his story with enough hope to leave us happy crying, too.
Boo?
Kitty.
Number 7, The Hunchback of Notre Dame.
I'm sorry, Master. I will never disobey you again.
Ringing the bells in Notre Dame Cathedral day in and day out, the Hunchback Quasimodo is shunned by the average citizen.
That's no mask.
It's his face. He's hideous.
In the Hunchback's battle to save his friend Esmeralda and the church itself from Claude Frollo, though, he earns a lot of goodwill. While Phoebus and Esmeralda's eventual romance could be viewed as upsetting for Quasimodo, seeing him embrace his new friendships is a much sweeter ending to his story.
Thank you.
it's virtually impossible not to cry with happiness when the people of Paris finally accept and actually celebrate the Hunchback. Plus, this resolution is all the more uplifting given how isolated Quasimodo's story starts out. Number 6. Finding Nemo. After nearly losing his son Nemo as a child, Marlin is an overly worried father who's scared to do anything remotely dangerous.
All right, we're excited. First day of school, here we go. We're ready to learn, to get some knowledge. Now, what's the one thing we have to remember about the ocean?
It's not safe.
That's my boy. So, first, we check to see that the coast is clear. We go out and back in.
And just as the two reunite after separate epic adventures, Nemo is almost fatally crushed in a net. Marlin's overwhelming concern is gut-wrenching, especially with the flashbacks to Finding Nemo's tragic opening scene.
Nemo? Nemo? It's okay. Daddy's here. Daddy's got you.
It's in this moment, however, that Nemo finally embraces his dad's excessive parenting and returns his love.
I don't hate you.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm so sorry, Nemo.
Though Marlin and Dory's emotional growth in Finding Dory is powerfully inspiring as well, Marlin's bouncy attitude in the closing moments of Finding Nemo is even more touching. Add in a final hug for good measure, and Finding Nemo ends with the perfect recipe for watery eyes.
Love you, Dad.
I love you too, son.
Dad, you can let go now.
Sorry!
Number 5. The Lion King. When Mufasa is killed, his son Simba is forced to leave Pride Rock and let Scar rule as a tyrant. Simba's exile unexpectedly molds him into a strong and lovable adult, however, who ends up defeating Scar. His affectionate welcome from the other lions is adorable and touching, but we burst into tears from all the warmth and love Simba lets out embracing Rafiki. The swelling music and roars only play on our emotions further before a ghostly message from Mufasa hits us right in the feels. The way The Lion King repeats the circle of life also closes the film on a note so cheerful that you'd have to be a robot not to cry. Number 4. The Fox and the Hound. A childhood of mischief turns Todd and Copper into caring friends, but they grow apart with adulthood.
Todd, I don't want to see you get killed.
Break him down, boy!
I'll let you go this one time.
This doesn't stop the fox from coming to the rescue, though, when the hound and his master are savagely attacked by a bear. Todd's bravery in the face of death is truly moving, and it leads Copper to defend his old pal from getting shot too. There's something woefully upsetting about seeing the hound deal with the conflict between his duty and his friendship as well. Though the fox survives, the tragic rift between the two friends is enough to cue the tears. And even with its glimmer of hope, the dark reality behind this ending sticks with you long after you stop watching. Number 3. Coco. An absent musician ancestor turns Miguel's family against music, but Miguel just wants to play guitar.
I don't care if I'm on some stupid ofrenda! No!
Mama! There. No guitar, no music.
This passion leads the boy through the land of the dead, where he meets Hector and learns his tragic story.
Where did you get this?
That's my mama Coco. That's my mommy Milda. Is that you?
We're
family?
When Miguel returns to his family, however, he rekindles Coco's memories with one of Hector's songs. The smile that breaks onto Coco's face easily melts your heart, while hearing her sing back is so beautiful that it gets us tearful.
Know that I'm with you, the only way that I can be. Until you're in my arms again.
it's the excitement Miguel's family has for music and their undead relatives in the movie's finale that keeps us weeping for all the right reasons. Number 2. Up. Carl sends his house to the skies to go on one last trip in memory of his late wife Ellie. Despite finding the young Russell annoying at first, the two unlikely friends bond over their adventures and hardships. While Russell doesn't seem to have anyone to present his scout badge upon returning home, it's a happy surprise to see Carl show up for him.
For assisting the elderly?
Russell? Is there someone that,
Excuse me. Pardon me. Old man coming through. I'm here for him.
Congratulations, Russell.
However, it's Carl's thoughtfulness to present Russell with his keepsake Ellie badge that sends us crying.
Russell, for assisting the elderly and for performing above and beyond the call of duty, I would like to award you the highest honor I can bestow. The Ellie badge.
The fact that both friends are still covered in dirt is a heartwarming detail as well. With all the sorrow Up begins with, the sweet and tender feeling in its closing moments is a wondrous change of pace.
So let's give a big explorer call to our brand new senior wilderness explorers. Ready, everybody?
There is one movie that gets me crying harder than any other, though. Can you guess? Here's some honorable mentions to keep you in suspense.
Eva?
Wally?
I love you, Daddy.
I love you so much. I'm really gonna miss you.
I'm gonna miss you too, kid. I really am.
Oh. Number 1. Toy Story 3. Though the goodbye between old friends in Toy Story 4 was devastating, we had to give the edge to the threequel. Andy's toys were thrown into a donation box in Toy Story 3, which got them trapped in a daycare and nearly killed in an incinerator. Given how dark and gloomy some of these moments played out, it was uplifting when they all came home. It was brutally sad, on the other hand, as Andy had to give his toys away and leave for school. Though each character has a story, Andy's reluctance to give up Woody brought out the tears.
Now Woody, he's been my pal for as long as I can remember. He's brave, like a cowboy should be, and kind and smart. But the thing that makes Woody special is he'll never give up on you.
And the scene hit extra hard for viewers given the long years between Toy Story films, which meant that many fans grew up with Woody and Buzz themselves. This mix of emotions was a roller coaster to watch, but satisfying nonetheless.
So long, partner.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from MsMojo. And be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.